heart with grief. They tortured your tender body, haunt your pretty eyes, and you did no mischief. They killed you only for your firm belief that this nation's pain one day will relieve. Your body fell, Leyla Qasim, but not your dream, not your grace. From Zaho to Xanaqin, your birthplace, the lands, the birds, the mountains, with tears on their face, cried, "Oh, Galan, where is our Leylan? Kicha ser bilindan, buka Kurdistan, killed by Fascistan. Let's all dance in her dilan, all together, jinu meran bigrin destan. Let's escape bahçe kulanu khaman, on her grave put destin gulan, halalu nergizu shilan. Tell her Avru Kurd azadin, idi finished bat sermanat zalin, frina serbahuina pishti zulma chant salu zaman. Oh, Kurdino, let's never forget Daja Saran. Always remember our brave lady. You might be wondering what I am doing here, looking at an old pair of shoes and smiling at an old mirror. Well, where do I begin to tell you a story? A story about how love can bring meaning to our lives, how real love means to sacrifice, whether this sacrifice is for the country and the land or is for the sake of the people we do love. My name is Tara, and I am Leyla's younger sister. And these things belongs to her. Leyla, the most brave woman I have ever seen in my life. Shining example of woman's heroism and bravery. A woman whose heart is filled with great courage and strength for the fight for her country. She sacrificed the most precious, herself and her love, for the sake of her strong beliefs. These beliefs which were never shaken till the last minutes of her life. Leyla has become a national legend and a role model for the young generation to come. Her body has left us long time ago, yet her soul is still with us ever since. Oppressed nations never forget their heroes. They always stay in the hearts and minds of their people. Among Leyla's dreams was to see this nation free. Today, her dreams are reality. Today, we all live her dreams. The story is about a place, we call it Kurdistan, and they call it the north of Iraq. It's Baghdad in early 70s, and Leyla, The beautiful, smart young woman is a student in the University of Baghdad. Her heart is filled with hope, love, and determination. Come, let's all together share her dreams. Come, let's together live her story.
It must be here again. Tara? Tara!
Sister.
Come here. Didn't I tell you not miss with my stuff while I'm not at home? But what?
I love you, Mara. It makes me beautiful.
Oh, my little pumpkin. You always look beautiful, not only in my mirror. When you grow up, you will have your own stuff. But now, you have to focus on your study and make us all proud of you.
I'm trying my best. Sis, is it true the Kurds people are Mukhribi?
No! Who told you that?
Our teacher. She said today the Mukhribi are bad people because they fought the government.
It's not true, darling. First, their names are Peshmergas, freedom fighters, not Mukhribi. Second, they never attack other people's land. All the time, it's they who come to our land. They invade. They destroy everything beautiful. But Peshmergas defend us. They fight for our rights.
Why they fought with us? Why they hate us?
Because they don't believe that we exist, that we are a different nation with our own language and culture.
So they name us Peshmerga, not Mukhribi. Maybe one day when I grow up, I'll be Peshmergas too.
You will make a good and brave one. But now you have to prepare your lessons. The revolution doesn't need only Peshmergas. But we need smart guests like you, who will be teachers, doctors, engineers as well. Because one day, you will rebuild what they destroyed today.
Okay, sis, I will. Good night.
Good night. Like a candle, to burn away in the fire of love, to burn away in the way to freedom.
Do you know what time is it? Why, you are not looking at me?
Oh, mother, is Dad home yet?
No. Why are you standing in the dark? And what is this candle for?
This is my candle. Like this candle, I might burn out. So there will be less darkness in this world.
I don't want you talking like that. Stop this nonsense. So ready to sacrifice yourself for the other. Throwing yourself into the fire. You don't know what you're talking about. Here, in the dark of the night. I want you to put an end to this and go to bed.
But I'm supposed to have an essay for my classes.
Write it tomorrow.
Mom, but I have plans for tomorrow.
What plans?
I'm going shopping with Nisma.
I need you down here. There are hundreds of things to do with your father absent most of the time.
What can he do, poor man? Working most of the day out to provide for us.
Right. So we should all help him. Now, go to bed.
Leyla, wake up. I have come for you.
Who are you?
I have come to take you home.
Home? Where? Where is that home?
First, you have to take the gift to make a choice.
I don't want this one. No. No. Not this either. I like the white. That's my color. That's my dress.
The choice is made. The choice is sacrifice.
I want to come to you.
I am there when you look for me.
Where are you?
Leyla!
I don't want to wake up.
Look for me.
Wait! I'm not done.
Come, when you are ready.
Don't leave me alone.
I will be waiting for you.
Wait! Wait! Where can I find you? Where?
Sweetie, are you okay?
Uh-huh.
It's okay. Mother is here. Speak to me. What is it?
Address. I need address. I told you, nobody will be around here in this time of the morning.
Let's do it before anyone comes.
Don't tell me you're afraid.
You know there's a lot of evil eyes watching. And I'm only worried about you.
Me? Why is that?
Because I'm a man.
I know that. And I'm a woman. You'd better be careful.
Listen, the point is...
Is what? What do you expect me to do? Stay home? Keep the rice cooking? And keep the babies coming? Listen, in the West, ladies first. Sweetie, he landed first. Because our land is taken. Our freedom is lost. So it's our duty, all men and women, to struggle together till we get both back.
But you don't understand. You don't know what these savage, dirty dogs can do to you if they get their hands on you. You will never even see the light again.
Do you call this living in the light? You are fine, as long as you don't say no to anything. But if you have the courage to oppose the regime, there is torture. There are executions. We've been living in this darkness enough for so long. Time has come. We should fight for our rights, our freedom. Don't we deserve to live like the others?
Darling, I know all this. We have to make sacrifices. And I'm ready to die for this cause. But sweetie, I don't want to lose you. I don't want to see you suffer.
Oh, darling, don't be silly. We will stay together forever. And we will have our little dream come true. A small house near the mountain. Get all together. And see our children grow up in a free Kurdistan.
No one knows the valley of freedom. Only the one who have never tasted. And no one knows the valley of the land. Only the one who have lost it.
You know, sometimes I think I'm a lucky girl.
Oh, really? And why do you think so?
Girls are dying to get one love. And I've got two. My lovely Kurdistan and darling you.
Now I feel jealous. And whom do you love more?
Come on. You know that you are two are my whole life. And each one of you has a special place in my heart.
But what if you have to choose? Whom would you sacrifice?
Who are you without a land? A group of shadows. Wandering in a strange land. And without you, I'll be lost too. Life will be meaningless.
I will be there for you. All the time. No matter what happens, you will find me beside you. I promise you.
I know I'm in good hands, so stop worrying about me.
Oh, by the way, I was downtown yesterday, and I bought you this.
Oh, how nice. It's beautiful.
Good morning, Miss Leyla.
Oh, morning, Doctor. Bewal, this is my teacher, Dr. Ali.
Nice to meet you, Doctor.
Nice to meet you, too. You know, Leyla is one of my best students. very energetic, and she makes a very good argument in the class.
How about her arguments? Don't tell me about it. I'm still trying to cope with it.
I have to go. I have a lecture. But don't forget about the exam tomorrow.
Exam?
Yeah.
I completely forgot.
Don't mind her, doctor. Her head is in the clouds.
Bewar.
But for now, her head should be in her box. Or she won't pass. Have a nice day. Bye.
Bye.
He seems to be a nice guy.
Dr. Ali is one of our favorite teachers. He's quite popular among the students. Oh, I just remember, I have an exam and this terrible essay to write.
What is it about? I might be able to help you.
Imagine, I have to write about the role of Baa'th in Arab unity.
We'll have fun. Quite an interesting subject. And you are the right person to write about it.
You are teasing me. What am I supposed to write about?
Just write to them what they like to hear.
But what they want to hear is a big lie?
Come on. You're overthinking this. Just write on the role of Baa'th in bringing peace and freedom to our country.
They destroy our village. They kill our friends. They try to erase our national identity, kill our culture. Yet, I have to praise them for struggling for the Arab unity.
Shh! Stop it. You forgot where we are standing.
But till when? We keep our mouths shut, our eyes closed. This never-ending oppression.
History did us wrong. They sold us for so long. Divided we stay all along. No one would hear our song. On high mountains we stand, the biggest nation without a land. A playing card in everyone's hand. A fact we all understand. Today, they are friends, hand in hand. Tomorrow, they sell us empty hand. Move us from this land to another land. We end up again, mass graves in desert sand. History repeats itself in this land. We are a playing card in everyone's hand, living like slaves in our own land.
We are victims of history. We are victims of superpower. They divided us into four parts, scattered in many lands. Then, we should not stand empty-handed. We have to overcome our fears. We have to scream out this injustice. Listen, I have an idea.
I said no. You must be crazy.
Come on, let's do it. Let people know our cause. Let the world hear our voice and feel our suffering.
Long live Kurdistan!
Long live the revolution!
Come on, people, join us so we can all have a better life, a better future.
Come to us so we can free our land from oppression, from tyranny.
Peace and freedom.
Freedom for Kurdistan. Democracy for the country. Down with the dictators.
Down with the regime.
Long live Kurdistan.
Long live the revolution.
We have nice dresses. Good morning, Eden. Here's your nice dress.
Come on. You complain like an old lady.
For God's sake, just tell me what are you looking for.
I know what I want. No. It's out there somewhere. No. I just have to find it.
Oh, that's cute dress out there.
for sale. We have nice dresses. Hello, ladies. I have got some nice dresses for you.
No, thanks. I'm not interested.
Very good prices, ma'am.
Don't you get it, boy? We're not interested in your junk. Why don't you just disappear?
Wait. Wait a second. Here. Look. This dress is made for you. Just for you and nobody else. Ma'am, you have to wear it.
Leyla? That's it. It's a good sign. Maybe we're getting married soon.
What?
It could be a wedding dress.
This is a nice dress. A beautiful dress. Look at that. Look how that will look on you. I swear, this dress is made specially for you.
You know, it's really strange. I had a dream recently, and I was wearing a white dress. This is just like a dress from my dream.
And was there a man in the dream?
Yes.
That's your future husband.
But I'm afraid. This dream was not about marriage.
Look, I'm just saying. There is a man, and there is a white dress. So what else it can be?
Maybe, but it was a kind of spiritual dream. Boy, how much you ask for it?
For you, miss. Just for you. Give me what I have paid for. 3 dinars.
What kind of cheap prices are you talking about? 3 dinars. This is our money for 1 month. We are poor students, boy.
Boy, I don't have that much.
Okay. In that case, maybe 2 then.
I will give you 1 dinar. That's all that I can pay. I'll keep it. I might wear it one day. You never know.
It's yours, ma'am. I'm sure you will wear it soon.
Here you have spent most of your money. So water, bread, for you all the rest of the month.
Well, at least I've got a dress. And now, I have to wait for the day to come.
Doesn't matter if one has to wait with an empty stomach.